ladies and gentlemen! Ladies and gentlemen! The new F1W is back! And tonight, we have a main event! TV One versus the Frasier versus Luscious Lou. Also, tonight, we have Dustin Dunbar, Deadly Evan Dustin Dunbar, facing off against Mike Hale, that dirty, slutty, skanky pedophile. This is actually the first Haunted Halloween we've ever done, actually on the day of Halloween, so that's a fun fact to chew on right there. Fuck this, let's get to it, folks! New F1W! Ladies and gentlemen, this is Dustin Dunbar's theme, his new theme, by some really gay band. Looks fucking wrapped for his match tonight, ladies and gentlemen. And a little more emotional than when we saw him last. So, I was looking at the card for tonight, so because, you know, wrestlers aren't always as informed as you guys think they are. You think that they know about their matches beforehand for months and months and months, but that wasn't so the case tonight when I went over to the little schedule here, and I see my name next to Mike Hale.
Oh, that's a shock. That's an absolute shock.
Mike Hale. You know what?
It's because you're so good.
Nothing against Mike Hale. In fact, I think he's one of the most talented people we have out on the roster, pound for pound.
Overstatement.
You know what? The thing about it is, Mike Hale, you screw it up.
God!
You just don't know how talented you are.
You know, it's funny, I got a little crimp to the music today. Pay attention to the lyrics, ladies and gentlemen, this is Mike Hale's new theme. We got a lot of complaints about pedophiles, so now we move it to I'll Get Inside You, and you may use your imagination with that. Look at that. Oh, that's fun. Cut the music. Cut it.
Clearly hear you say that I'm not good.
Well, something like that.
Actually, you didn't. You actually rudely interrupted my conversation. What I was going to say is that you are one of the best superstars we have here at FYW, but you fuck it up. You fuck it up every single time. There's always these little details that you decide to brush to the side that end up spelling your demise in the end. Now, if you can just...
Like having sex with a bodacious sister.
Focus! You can be one of the best people we've ever had here. But you're so thick-headed that nobody can get it through your fucking skull how good you are. I was good enough to beat you. And I'll do it again. Tonight. All I'm asking, Mike...
Dramatic!
You do it tonight. And I'll drop everything I just said about you. You beat me here tonight, and I will extend my hand and shake yours. You got it? Huh? will then allow me to extend my hand first.
Oh, punch to the face. Typical Mike Hale. Yeah, why don't you take his pants off too, you faggot? Oh, that's into the tree. Into the tree we have it. Yeah, it's been a while since we have had FYW. Probably about 3 or 4 months. And I don't know how shapely these guys are right now. He's got some kind of choke thing on. Oh, Jesus. That looked like a stunner. That looked like a stunner on Mike Hale. His monkey ass. Oh, right to the face. Mike Hale's down again. And Dustin Dunbar has the swift advantage. That's a one, two, no. That's a two count. Mike Hale seems to, Oh, that's... Eye gouge! Oh, well, a few elbows. He's gonna hit him up with a suplex. Nope, I lied. Oh. Looks like a bulldog. Yeah, you shut your mouth. Yeah, why don't you shut your mouth? Oh, knee the gut, too. Ouch! Rockland Dropper by Dustin Dunbar, Shades of TV One. One, two, oh, never mind. The push-up splashes, the mini push-up splashes. One, two, shoulders up. One, two, oh, kick out. He got a kick out. He got his shoulder up. So. Mike Hale, not quite dressed for the match, I'd say. Oh, looks like he just got back from some kind of show with the Underground. Oh, just give him some kicks to the stomach. Three kicks to the stomach. So he's gonna hit him up with a suplex. No, I lied. More knees. Knee to the back. He's totally taking out that midsection. That's actually intelligent on the part of Dustin Dunbar, and you've never heard me say it before. He's stretching out that back. Stretching out that back. Mike Hale looks like a freaking doofus right now. Oh, Jesus. Flatliner. Flatliner, that was my shadow. Flatliner. And Mike Hale. Oh, look at the agony. I love it. It's fantastic. The look on that face.
Ah, you son of a bitch!
Is old Merle again commentating this match? Folks, in case you were wondering. Picking him back up. I don't know what's going to happen here. Man, believe me that. Oh, that was a stiff, death-like DDT. And that is coming straight from the heart, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know what happened to his neck. One, two, shoulder up. That's gonna cause some spasms, let me tell you what. Right, Michael?
Damn right.
Yeah, that's right. Got to move back on him now.
My face is too pretty for this!
This almost looks sexual in this light. And he's got kind of a choke, I guess. He's got a choke, but there's no rules, that's alright.
Come on. He's fading.
He is.
He's fading.
He's done. I'm circling around these guys now just to keep it dramatic. Come on, guys.
Where's the ref for this?
I'm right here. I'm still here. I'm not leaving. Oh.
Oh, yeah.
That's one, baby.
Oh, yeah. Come on, it's all over.
Two.
Oh, man.
Look at that sexy armor line. They call this match just a walk in the park. Nope. Oh, big stunner. Big stunner. Michael just flopped to my feet.
Knock it off.
Just waking up, man. I don't want the match to end this soon. Give him the kick. Call him a son of a bitch, I think he said. Oh, knee to the stomach. Is Deadly Dreams? Deadly Dreams, good night. Mike Hale is laid out. And if Dustin Dunbar can just get the pin here, Mike Hale's not moved. And neither have his pants. So I guess we're all in good shape right now. One, two, nope, shoulder up. Oh, he got him. Cripple across face. He's fading. Okay, he's got him in a Rings of Saturn time. No, pin. One, two, nope, shoulder up. One, two, shoulder up. Get him back in the rings of Saturn, it looks like. I just kind of picking him up. So he's kind of setting him up for unprettier, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Does no more flopping like a fish. And Mike Hale just looking to get a pinfall here. You gotta think, I mean. I got something better. You guess I doubt it, but we'll find out.
Need a little prop here. This will work.
Prop him up against a tree. Looks kind of like a la Samoa Joe. Okay, just speared the tree, but the tree's not moving. That's for fuck sure. And Dustin Dunbar just moved right out of the way at the last second. One, two, three. That's the pinfall, ladies and gentlemen. Dustin Dunbar has won this match. He did it. He did it. Against that pedophile, he did it.
Get your shit together.
Look at that. Check out the physique Dustin Dunbar's got on. Looks like he's been to the gym a little bit. Mike Hale's out, ladies and gentlemen, after spearing a tree. I wouldn't put it past him. Let's get on to the main event, ladies and gentlemen! God!
Get ass quick!
This is Yoshihiro Tanaka here, commentating the main event! And here is the world champion, CB1!
And what a main event we have here tonight. That triple threat match that we've been awaiting for a long time. A couple changes made to the match. But it should still be one of the greatest matches in Hell on Halloween history. And look how focused, look how determined the world champion looks tonight. I'm sorry if I sound a bit winded, folks. I was just on a 10K run before the match here tonight, and what the hell is he doing?
And here he is, determined.
I was hot, so I had to get some water.
Determined and hot and hydrated now.
And his long awaited return! Could it be? It is the T-Bone! Returning here tonight in the absence of the Luscious One! And this is a big opportunity for T-Bone, making his return not too long ago, and tonight, wrestling for the FYW Championship. What a return it is. What a return it could be for T-Bone. And you know what that means. Awaiting the arrival of one more, and here he is! Wait for it, but it is worth every moment. one, the champion defending against the Frazier Blade and T-Bone. And here we go, this could start off explosive, and oh my god, a gigantic spear from TB1, who by the way is wearing a very unflattering shirt. Oh, sweet Buddha, this is insane, and a DDT, stiffest I've ever seen it. One, two, and a kick out. Very resourcefulness. Oh my, and a low blow was gonna say very resourceful of T-Bone to go for that pin right off, because you never know when you can get the victory. And TB1 putting those patented boots right to the chest. And a giant leg drop. One, two, kick out. And that could have been an early victory for TB1. You saw the T-Bone just got his shoulder up on that one. And very innovative of TB1, the Bulldog on the T-Bone, who already took that leg drop. One, two, and now somehow he gets the shoulder up again. Softening, Frazier up, and a double arm DDT. Not going for the pin here. I don't know how smart that is. And a cocky pin, one, two, no! And that's not gonna do anything, that's just gonna piss Frazier off. And it did. God, and returning the favor. One, two, no. And this is going to be as brutal as it can get. You know, with these three competitors, they aren't going to hold anything back. The most important thing in the world to them is that FYW championship. And you could really say that the FYW championship is the drug of TB1's choice. And a giant enziguri! Oh my god! A landstorm-like kick right to the face there! And go for the cover, one, two, and somehow, the Frazier Blade gets that shoulder up.
Rass! Now that the hair, it's yours! Oh.
Well, I don't know how accurate that is. Frazier's hair isn't very long. Softening him up once again, and could it be? I think it is the Rockland Dropper, executed perfectly. Calling for T-Bone to get up. And hooking the arms for a pedigree! Pedigree, I'm not sure if he got all of it, but it may be enough. He gets a one, two, no! And if you're just joining us here, in which case you're an idiot because you missed the entire pay-per-view, this is the triple threat match for the FYW Championship. Oh! And delivering those right hands straight to TB1's face. Oh. And a huge drop kick. And TB1, he might be dead. And a giant maneuver. Going for the pinfall here. for the 1, 2, and TB1, being the crafty champion that he is, breaks that up.
Not today.
Not today, he says. And TB1, he's got that championship belt. Gouda. And a stiff shot to the face of Frazier. And this could be it. 1, 2, he's got it now. And T-Bone, locking in an ankle lock. Locking it in an ankle lock. And let me tell you, those are no fun. They constrict the blood flow to the ankle and to the rest of the leg. And if he doesn't... Oh, my! I was going to say, if he didn't let that up, he could have very well broken that ankle of the champion. Not that the match would have been stopped. But definitely a disadvantage going through the match with a broken ankle. And now working on that knee of TB1. And another one, T-Bone being very cerebral at the moment. Setting up, could it be a suplex? Yes! And it is! It's the three dancing Scotsmen! And he hit that third dancing Scotsman! Dancing all over the place. 1, 2, oh my God! And that is not a way you want somebody to break up a pin. TB1 stalking whoever gets up first. And it's T-Bone, unfortunately, and down he goes! And he's out cold. T-Bone is out cold. With the Frazier Blade! Frazier Blade getting that bat out of the hands of TB1, and now he has it in his hands. And this is not good. Oh my God! The Frazier showing off those baseball skills. And that is a perfect swing. TB1 just getting up. Gonna dish out some more punishment, it seems. After just taking that baseball shot, it's amazing that TB1 can even get to his feet. And what are they setting up for here? Oh, double clothesline! They are both down! And T-Bone looking to capitalize for the 1, 2, no! Frazier just getting that shoulder up, going for another 1, 2, and Frazier breaks it up!
Help me. Please!
And a hog lock! Oh my God! Oh my God! That has to be it! That has to be it! 1, 2, T-Bone! It's a good thing T-Bone got there, because I do not think that Frazier would have kicked out of that one on his own. And delivering some straight left hands to the face. And a DDT straight into the ground, driving that head to the floor. 1, 2, TB1. And it's a good thing these men have been on their game as far as the pinfalls go, because I do believe there could have been a lot of pinfalls in this match that could have gone through already. Light it up with water and deliver the shots. And a stiff left hand. And Frazier hydrating himself might be a good idea. Oh, but no! Opens himself up for a kick.
Surprise.
And another!
In my mouth. Oh!
Oh, my God!
Oh, geez.
Go for the pin. One, two, no!
Where's that water?
And TV1 is an idiot. Oh! And you never know how far hydration can go in a match. T-Bone was taking out that knee again, working on the knee to stutter! Stutter patented stutter from T-Bone, one of the best in the business! At a low blow. Frazier dragging the T-Bone out into a sharpshooter. Into a sharpshooter. And he could tap out any second. I think he's gonna go. Oh my God. This is ruthless. And those ribs quickly being taken out on the Frazier. Did not have a problem with his ribs before this, but after those three straight shots, they may be broken. And a huge splash, one, two, and somehow, some way, the determination of Frazier gets the shoulder up. T-Bone, oh my! Sweet Buddha! One, two, no! And what do you have to do? I have to ask, what do you have to do to get one of these men, to get one of these men to stay down for the one, two, three? It is seeming damn near impossible at this point. Delivering those straight right hands to the face. Stalking with the chair, and he ducks it. And another stutter. First to TV1 and now to Frazier. And he may have this one won. Frazier's out of the equation. Can he get the pinfall? One, two. Oh, and a sneaky but resourceful kick out from TB1 pointing to his head, and I have to agree with that one. That was smart.
My water bottle.
Have you ever tried this? Straight or Joe's.
We do not have time for commercial time, TB1. Thank you very much. Get back to your match,
please. What's wrong with these shows?
And could it be going? Could it be going? Oh, inverted stunner! Flopping like a fish. And T-Bone, one, two, what is this? T-Bone trying to get the cover off that inverted stunner, but it did not go. And now TB1 may mean business, taking off those elbow pads, and he has the baseball bat. Stalking. And he has it in his grasp.
Oh!
and a duck from the fighter and into a giant super kick. And this one could be over if he could just get his hand over there to cover TB1. He's going, he's crawling, and he's got it. One, two, it's over. No! The T-Bone saw.
Somebody make me.
The T-Bone saw an opening. And he's going. Bonebreaker! Onto the belt! And it's one, two, oh! And a stunner to T-Bone! Returning the favor! Slidebuster!
Over there.
And I am being directed by the phrase. Ah! And that huge razor-like elbow, freezer-like elbow. One, two, three. He's got it. He did it! And the new champion! The new champion after this hectic match! The elbow was enough! That stabbing like elbow! To the... Oh! Fraser Blade! And soaking up the victory is Fraser! He is the three-time FYW champion! The Fraser! And what hell? What hell he had to go through here on Hell on Halloween to capture this third FYW championship title? And raising it in celebration. And you earned it, my friend. You earned it. And T-Bone is exhausted. TB1 is unconscious. And the Fraser is the three-time FYW champion extraordinaire. Somebody's confusing all.